Welcome to PCB Heaven Tech Labs. In this video, I will demonstrate my new circuit, which is a single infrared LED decoder and transmitter using the Philips RC5 transmission protocol. This circuit is actually the proof of concept for this design. I plan to make a larger project with infrared transmission, and I found this method to make the transceiver more compact. The idea is based on the fact that when light falls on a reverse biased PN contact of an LED, a small current will appear proportional to the light intensity. Although this current is in the scale of microamperes, it is still enough to use the LED as an effective receiver. Here is a schematic of this idea. Suppose that this is a normal or infrared LED. The anode and the cathode are then connected to the outputs of a microcontroller. A small resistor is connected to the cathode to limit the current and protect the LED from overcurrent when it operates as a transmitter. A much higher resistor is connected to the anode in the range of kilo-ohms. This resistor will be used to generate a measurable voltage drop from the small reverse current when the LED operates as a receiver. Suppose now that we want to set the circuit to operate as a receiver. Since we have to reverse bias the LED, the cathode output of the peak is driven high and the anode output is driven low. If we then probe the anode of the LED with an oscilloscope, when light pulses fall onto the PN contact of the LED, we will discover that these pulses will appear across the large resistor, because the small reverse current caused by this light will cause a large voltage drop across the big resistor. So we only need to connect this point to a high impedance input of the microcontroller and the receiver is ready. Now suppose that we want to set this circuit to operate as a transmitter. First of all, the cathode output must become low to forward bias this LED. Then we do a trick to remove the large resistor out of the circuit. The trick is to make the anode output as an input and drive it into the high impedance state and make the input that we used before to receive the pulses into an output. Now watch what happens. When the peak sends pulses through this port, current will go through the LED, through the limiting resistor, down to the output which is driven low. I made this circuit to test the idea, which works just fine. It has of course the limitation that it cannot provide higher current than the maximum current of a peak port, which is typically 25 mA. When power is provided to the circuit, it runs a loop to check if an RC5 signal is received. This remote control operates with the RC5 protocol. I approach the transmitter LED close to my circuit's LED and press a button. The receiver then recognizes and decodes the button pressed. Then it displays on this LCD the toggle bit state, the address number and the button code. Additionally, it saves the last received data to the EEPROM of the peak. By pressing this button, the circuit is turned into a transmitter and transmits the saved data previously received. Every time that the button is released, the toggle bit is updated normally, as it happens with the normal remote controls. Additionally, keeping the button pressed sends the data repeatedly with 90 milliseconds interval delay. I didn't add more push buttons and memory positions because, as I said in the beginning of this video, this circuit is just the proof of concept for the single LED transceiver. As always, you can find complete documentation in my website with the circuit schematics and the PIC software to download. Thank you for watching this video and don't forget to visit my website for more interesting circuits.